In this video, I'm going to show you how I replace two broken gate valves in copper pipe to quarter turn ball valves in PEX A pipe. I used a PEX A expansion tool with the matching fittings. The whole setup was surprisingly cheap, and even easier was it using it, and I've never used it before. So let's just get into it. The initial problem was the rubber flapper underneath that was coming off. When I went to turn this off, that is the first one that broke. And over here is where the bathroom is. The toilet supply line goes that way. That's a half inch, it branches onto a 3/4 inch pipe. And there's the valve that's broke. You can see it's been corroding there. This one needs to be changed too, but I'm just gonna do one today. Initial little plans here for doing to get in the shopping list or what to get at the Home Depot or Lowe's. It turns out Home Depot has a lot more in stock and I needed to get this done, so I'm gonna go there. Plus, my son is going to a basketball practice right by this Home Depot, so it works out pretty good. This is gonna be supplying the toilet. Here's a half inch line, PEX, 3/4 inch line, PEX. That's way cheaper than the copper line. Partially why I want to do that, but mainly because it's a lot easier to work with. There's a shark bite. Now I'm just kind of trying to bite the bullet to get those. I mean, that's really expensive for coupling. Barbell, 10 bucks. PEX A expansion toolkit, 116. And you know, that's ouch. My total for supplies has got to be around $200. So that's quite a good deal considering a plumber would cost, you know, far, far more than that. And although it'd be easier, I wouldn't have this sweet tool and I wouldn't gain the knowledge of this. You know, it's kind of one of those teach yourself to fish type situations. All right, back from the store. I'll tell you, anytime you get the chance to order online and do a curb pickup or a in-store pickup, so much better. Problem is, they gave me a different one. I did not pay for this. I did not want this. Now I gotta go back to the Home Depot. Regardless of that, my goal tonight, bare minimum, is to put this ball valve on so I can turn this off and return water to the rest of the house. Let's crack open this expansion toolkit. Already has some lube on there. Let's put the lube on. Oh boy. Oh, okay. Got a little spring action there. Cool. Still spitting that. I'm gonna see if I can't cut this square. It's not perfectly square, but it's better than what it was. At least it's straight across. If it has a slight bend of it, I don't think it will matter. We'll see. If you notice, this does not fit on there. That's the point of the whole system. So they have a lip on one side. Slide across. Mind you, this is the first time I've ever done this. Oh, pretty tight. And you can't push it past that. Once you get it all the way on there, I suppose you proceed to this dilly-dall. Let's see. Oh boy. This is kind of hard to do this. We'll stay, keep it in the camera. You always want to rotate this thing. So this is now ready to stick on my 3/4 inch copper line. That being said, looking at it closer, I think I could switch this around. So instead of here to here, it moves here to here. Perfect, look at that. Beautiful. All right, let's cut this off. All right. Let's take that off. Even with this, man, yeah, that's what I'll do. Cut
little bit more. Oh boy, steel on brass, I gotta be careful there. There we go, whew, man. It's out of angle because this stupid blade here, I need to get a new one of these. It's only sharpened on one side, so when it cuts in, it always cuts at an angle. So I get down here and look at what I have set up. This line right here, it's not against the wall. There's a good 5 inches between there. So I'm also not gonna be able to use these little screw things. Right, so in order to do this, I'm gonna have to turn off my main water valve. What the heck is this? Oh boy. Stand by. Right. I found it. I thought it was on the right side, but I guess it's on the left side. And when we bought the house, this thing leaked. I hate these valves. These twist valves just suck. Always get a quarter turn valve. Ugh. I've opened up all the faucets upstairs to drain out the lines upstairs, and this is the basement. So hopefully all the water will come down here and mainly drain up in here rather than coming through that tube when I cut it. Here is the valve that's malfunctioning, and I'm gonna cut it right to the left of it, all the way to right here. I'm gonna replace that with a PEX A. All right, let's cut this. I'm gonna connect it right about there. Excellent. All right, so we got that broken off and nice and clean. There it is. Ooh. Oh, no, no, no. Now we got some clearance here. Let's go ahead and shove this on. This is nice and clean. Beautiful. There we go. Woo. Open. Closed. That's closed. Let's turn the main valve back on. Oh boy, that was not good. I turned the valve back on. Oh gosh. Lesson learned, if you open up all your faucets and stuff to let the cold water drain out, when you turn the cold water back on, it's also got to turn the hot water back on. And if all the faucets are on in the middle of hot and cold water, well, the hot water is going to flow in to that mixing valve and flow down the opposite way of the cold water, which is why this was coming out. If anything was in there, I flushed it all out. This is completely clean now, so really happy with that. All right, bathroom valves are turned completely off, so I'm gonna turn the water main back on. Hopefully that will not leak. It should. No, guys! No! Alright, so I went upstairs and ends up I forgot to turn off the tub faucet. Hopefully that does not shoot water out this time. Oh boy, here it comes. The water. Oh. That's scary. Oh! Yes! Yes! All right, so here is the hardest part. It's gonna connect this long portion to here. Well, it's not gonna be that hard, but The big reason that I wanted to go to PEX is because this is so pliable and bendable. You won't need to deal with being exact or slip couplings or anything like that with solder. You just kind of bend what you need in slack and then you gotta slip it on with this guy.
All right.
Let's push this on here. Let me cut. I just gotta say right here. All right, let's hope this fits. All right, it's together. Let's see what leaks. Oh, something's leaking over there. Yeah, so it is leaking indeed. But it's leaking because I forgot to connect the hose. Fixing some plumbing. All right, test number two. Hopefully it won't leak this time. That is great sound. Yes, done.